I have so much energy right now because I ate a lot of ice cream, so I gotta record this video before my sugar crash. So let's get to these questions. Hey guys, welcome back, or if this is your first time here, my name is Brandon, and welcome to A Place for Melodic Metal Guitarists. Today we have a few questions that we're going to answer. The first one has to do with Reaper, so I'm going to show you a bit of that on my screen. So our first question comes, I'm not really sure how you run this together. I'm just going to say I'm hand. How do you get the timer just a couple of metronome hits before recording actually starts? And what I believe he's talking about is in Reaper where it counts in before you start playing or recording. So what you do is you go up to the metronome in Reaper and you right click, and then you can choose to count in before playback or count in before recording. So that means when you hit record or you hit the play button, it'll count in first. And then you can choose your count in measures. How many measures do you want it to count in before it actually starts? And also, here's a bonus. Metronome sound. Have you guys ever tried to play around with these before? I've downloaded several different sounds from different DAWs, and so I like to change it out every now and then, so that's kind of a cool tip. And the second question was how to have a part of one track be a separate effect. So like basically he's talking about switching off effect one or the other. Should you create another track, or can you do it on one track? And you can do it on just one track. This is called an envelope. Whatever guitar track or whatever track you're using, you locate the envelope tool. Just click that and it'll pull up little parameters, little check boxes of every single effect that you have on that track. And so let's just say that I wanted to effect an EQ there. Let's just say I wanted the high pass to be automated. Selected that checkbox, I can go back down here, the envelope, and you see that it's opened it up. I can hold down the shift button and this turns into an arrow tool where I can just modify this where I need, you know, add however many points I want it, and then I can modify this track. So now when it plays, it's going to change on its own. See here on the, see how it moved by itself? Because I had it automated. He wanted delay at one point and delay not. So what I'd probably use is the wet filter on that. I wouldn't use bypass because that can be rather jarring. It doesn't sound as good. And plus you have to time it just perfectly. But if you use the wet filter, you can select it to go from 0 to 100 in an instant or whatever. That way you're controlling the volume of the delay at the same time. Our second question comes from Brandon. Also, he's asking me, can you please tell me how you make your drums? I use Superior Drummer, and I use the Avatar kit sometimes, but then I also use the Metal Foundry. So it just kind of comes down to what I'm going for, what I feel like using. I switch between the two, and I've downloaded a couple of presets from people from times, and I do have a tutorial on drum programming in general, just the basics of it. So you can check the card pop out and you can follow that to my recreation series. Now, Superior Drummer is too pricey. You can also check into Easy Drummer. I'm sure there's other drums out there. Guys, if you have knowledge of drum kits out there that are free that you can use as like a drum machine, post those in the comments below. And our next question comes from Kima95. He's asking me, are you have any tips on practice schedules? I'm not really a guy to ask about schedules. I just practice when I can find time, especially since I have a full-time job and I run this YouTube channel. But I guess I would say just try picking a subject, try picking a topic that you want to focus on. Let's just say pinch harmonics. Well, pick an artist or pick a song that has a lot of pinch harmonics and learn that. There are a lot of lessons out there that will teach you specific techniques. So for example, I have recently joined back at guitarmasterclass.net. And if you want to join that site along with me, I have a referral link since I'm a member in the description. So if you want to sign up through there, you get a discount. But on that site, there are a lot of lessons that you can choose from that do teach you a lot of different techniques. And the reason I thought of pinch harmonics was because Tron Vold, who is an instructor there, actually has a short song on pinch harmonics, and almost the whole song is pinch harmonics. I would just say practice when you can on what you're wanting to learn. Follow for Nothing asks, do you cook? Do you have any rocking food ideas? I don't really cook. My mom's tried to get me into doing a little bit more cooking for myself, which I should. I guess I've cooked a few things, eggs, soup. Not a whole bunch of different things have I really cooked. Is either a sandwich or a wrap. Most of it's organic stuff. Some of it's not organic stuff. Chicken, heart of romaine, avocados, mayonnaise, horseradish, and I like the Bubby's horseradish because it's probiotic and it's just really good. So my food ideas are definitely not rocking, but yeah, I'm a pretty simple guy when it comes to food, I suppose. Mariano, I hope I said your name correctly, asks, hey, I'm quite new at commenting, but do you plan to collaborate with other channels like Rob Scallon, Fluff, Music is Win, or Jared Dines? Well, to be honest, I don't think that any of those guys are in my league. I think they're like way up there. I'm a little bitty guy with 14,000 subscribers. Those guys have so much more. I don't really know how to reach out to those guys because it feels like, what do they have to gain, really? I mean, I'm a small channel. They're not really going to gain a whole bunch unless they were just being completely nice. I guess the only tie that I have is Fluff. On his Facebook page, he put out an ad of saying, hey, I'm selling my license for Superior Drummer. First one who messaged me gets it. And I beat, like he said, 10 guys out by just a few seconds. So I was the first one. So maybe if I were to say, hey, I'm the guy that bought Superior Drummer from you, maybe that would be something. All right, and our next question comes from Philip Zane Music. Now, his first part of the question asked the same as what we've already answered. So we'll skip over that. But he had another question within this one. He asked me if I have any shredding tips. You have to start slow. You really do have to start slow and play with a metronome. You want it to be consistent as you bring it up to speed. If you don't have a metronome, your fingers are going to learn inconsistently. So you may have some parts that you can play really well, but then you may have the part that you can't play very well that may be slower, that may be inadvertent, and it may just be ever so slightly still. If you want it to be tight, it's got to be consistent. And of course, the obvious one is don't rush. You will grab some sort of muscle memory from your practice. So just be sure to not teach your fingers the wrong muscle memory. If you keep messing up in a passage, force yourself to stop and focus on that specific passage. Because if you keep playing, like, oh, skip over it, you know, just I rush through it, it messes up, but that's okay. This other part sounds cool and I want to play this. Your fingers are remembering that. It's going to get more ingrained. And then when you finally start to try to learn it correctly, it's going to be even harder because your brain has remembered the wrong way to do it. So that's why you have to teach it slowly until you can do it almost mindlessly. Now, another thing that I would recommend, because I'm speaking from experience here, try, if you can, practice right before bed, and then maybe right when you get up. If you can't do it right when you wake up, that's okay. But I would definitely try to do it right before you go to bed. Try practicing your piece. I don't know, maybe just 5-10 minutes right before you go to bed. Your brain is going to kind of subconsciously work on that as you sleep. It's kind of like, you know, when they say, oh, I'm going to sleep on it, you know, and then maybe they think of the answer. Maybe they even wake up in the middle of the night and they know the answer to a problem that they've been thinking about because the subconscious mind has been thinking about it. I have found that if I practice right before bed, by the time, even if I don't practice right in the morning, maybe it's the next afternoon, the next day, I come back and revisit the passage and I'm like, hey, this is easier. Anyway, that's just a theory, but it really makes sense. I may be the only one in the world that has experienced that, but I definitely would try that out. I'm sure I'm not the only one, and if any of y'all have experienced that, I'd love to hear about it in the comments as well. All right, and our last question is from George. He's asking me, how do you practice the last part of the solo in Bark at the Moon by Ozzy Osbourne? It's impossible to play 20 plus notes in 4 seconds. Well, that, I went and listened to it because I hadn't really heard it before, maybe one time or something, but I looked it up and I was like, okay, that's out of my league for sure. So I'm definitely with you there. The one thing that I might recommend on that specific solo, it looks like that you could pretty easily incorporate some hammer-ons and pull-offs. So maybe instead of picking every single note, you could maybe pick every other note or pick every three notes. I give that a try. Sometimes when you don't alternate pick everything, it can be really helpful. And I've done that before too. Well guys, I guess that about wraps it up today. So if you have any questions of your own, please leave those below and I will answer any way I can. I typically will answer first and then put them in the episode. That way you don't have to wait until the video comes out so you get your question answered right away. But then again, everyone else watching the video gets to benefit from your question and the answer. I post every Wednesday and Saturday, so if you haven't subscribed already, then please consider doing so. I will see you this Saturday, and thank you guys so much for watching. I can feel the sugar wearing off, so I think we finished right about the right time.